Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. This week, we are going to go over keyboard shortcuts. The more you use Excel, the more you start realizing that the keyboard becomes a very efficient way to get tasks done in Excel. So knowing these keyboard shortcuts helps you to be a lot faster as an Excel user. So we are going to go over different categories of keyboard shortcuts this week. The first category is just common shortcuts. You probably know many of these, but hopefully there's one or two in there that you don't already know. The second one is how to access the ribbon by using the keyboard. The third one is what are all of these function keys at the top of the keyboard? And then I would like to go over a quick way to navigate through your spreadsheet just using your keyboard. And then finally, we'll do a bunch of miscellaneous, really helpful, useful shortcuts to help you become more proficient at Excel. We're going to continue using our vendor spreadsheet from last week just to be able to have a way to show you what some of these different shortcuts are on the keyboard. So the first four shortcuts I would like to demonstrate are some of my favorites, and these are ones that I've been using forever. They are copy, cut, paste, and undo. So to copy a cell, just click on a cell and hit Control C on the keyboard. If I want to put that same text somewhere else, I just click on another cell and then I hit Control V to paste. However, if I want to click on this cell and I no longer want the contents of that cell in that cell, but I want to move them somewhere else, I would hit Control X on the keyboard for cut and then click on a new cell and again hit Control V, and I have now cut it from one place and pasted it to another, whereas in the first one, I copied it, left the original, and then pasted it to a new cell. So if I would like to undo that one, I can hit Control Z on the keyboard, and that undoes my previous action. If I hit Control Z again, it will also undo two actions before that. So you can hopefully see how these become very useful when you know how to use them on the keyboard. Next, I would like to show you some spreadsheet level shortcuts. If I hit Control O, I will be taken to the open spreadsheet screen right here. If I go back and I hit Control S, I will have saved my current workbook that I'm working in. Control P opens up my print dialog and I can see all of my printing options. And then Control B can bold, Control U will underline, and Control I will put the text into italics for you. So those are some of the more common, more often used shortcuts on the keyboard. Next, I would like to show how to access the ribbon without using the mouse. So if I'm typing along in my spreadsheet and I hit Alt F, I will go to the file menu. And if you notice over here, look at all these letters that just appeared. If I hit any of those letters, like the O, I will automatically be taken to that place on the screen. So it's very helpful once you know what your options are to get to the different ribbons. You don't have to memorize all of these because Excel is going to tell you what to hit next. So I'm going to hit the back button. And now if I hit Alt H, I will go to the home ribbon. And once again, you can see that all of the letters have appeared where I can hit pretty much any option on my ribbon just using my keyboard. If I hit Alt N, I can access the insert ribbon and so on for each one of the ribbons inside of Excel. Right now, I'm going to display what the alt characters are for each of the different ribbons up top. So let's go over how to move about the ribbon once you have accessed it from the keyboard. Again, I'm going to hit Alt H. If I hit the right arrow, I will start going through different options on the home ribbon. If I hit Tab, same thing. I will go through each one in order. If I get to an option that has a drop-down box, I can hit the down arrow and I will be able to see all of my options. Once I'm on a command that I would like to use, like bold, I can hit enter and you can see that the ribbon still remains, but the action was taken on the word poor. So if I do it again and hit enter, you can see that the bold was taken off. If I hit escape, I can exit the ribbon. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. Next, let's look at some of the function buttons. The function keys are across the top of the keyboard and they start with the letter F. Sometimes you have to hold down the function key before you can hit the F1 or the F2. It depends on what kind of keyboard you have. But in my case, I do have to hold down function. And if I hit F1, you will see that the help menu appears. Now, there are other things I can do with F1. Say I exit out of the help menu. If I hit down Control F1, I can now see the ribbon. And if I hit Control F1 again, that will hide the ribbon. If I select some data and then I hit Alt F1, a chart will automatically be created. If I hit Alt Shift F1, you can see that a new worksheet has been inserted. How about if I hit Function F2? You can see that the cursor is now blinking and I've now entered edit mode into this cell. So if I backspace, I can edit the name of this vendor. I'm just going to put vendor 1 back in, but so that you can see that that is what function F2 does. If I hit Shift F2, I can now add a note to the current cell that I am on. Then if I hit Control F2, I will go to the print screen, just like if I had hit Control P. F3 is a little more complicated, so I'm just going to skip ahead to F4. Say I had copied and pasted a cell earlier on. If I hit Function F4, I can paste that again. It is going to repeat my last action. Control F4 will close my current workbook. I'm going to hit Cancel because I really don't want that to happen right now. And Alt F4 will close Excel completely. But again, I'm going to cancel because I want to stay within Excel. F6 is one that is really helpful. It's kind of hard to see, but if you watch, I hit Function F6, you will see that any other tabs in this spreadsheet have been selected. So if I hit Function F6 and then I hit the left arrow key and then I hit Enter, I will be taken to another tab in my spreadsheet. If I hit F6 twice, I will be taken to this menu down here at the bottom of my screen. Usually you can record a macro or tab over to all of these other options like the zoom window. If I hit Function F6 three times, then I will be taken up to the ribbon. And again, you can see this is a quick shortcut up there, which letter I can hit to access which ribbon. So if I were to hit P, I can go right to page layout. And again, all of my letters are displayed up there. So I'm going to hit escape to exit that. So F6 allows you to toggle between the menu on the bottom of the screen, the zoom controls, the tabs inside of a spreadsheet, and also the ribbons across the top. F7 is for everyone who loves grammar and spelling. When I hit F7, I will run my spell check. Hitting Function F8 helps me to use the arrow keys to select all of the cells above me, like this, hitting the up arrow, or hitting the down arrow, or hitting the right, or hitting the left. Alt F8 brings up the macro window. So if you're using macros often, that's going to be a good one to know. Shift F11 opens a new worksheet, and F12 opens the Save As dialog box. Next, let's review some of the arrow keys. Down, right, up, left. Those are pretty straightforward. But once I'm on some of my data, if I hit Control Down, I'm going to go to the end of my data set. But if I hit Control Down again, I'm going to go to the very end of the spreadsheet. If I hit Control Up, I'm going to go to the bottom of my data set again. And if I hit Control Up, I'm going to go to the top of my data set. Hit Control Up one more time, I'm at the top of my spreadsheet. If I hit Control Right, I'm at the end of my spreadsheet. If I hit Control Left, I'm back at the beginning. And so if there's a data set in the middle of the direction that I'm going, I will stop at the beginning and end of that data set. But if there is nothing left under there, I will go to all four corners of the spreadsheet. Control Home will take me to the beginning of the spreadsheet always, into cell A1. Control Alt Plus will zoom in a couple times, and Control Alt Minus will zoom out. So here's a couple fun ones. Shift Space will select a whole row within my table, and Control Space will select a whole column. If I wanted to quickly be able to filter data, I could hit Control Shift L, and that would turn on my filters. And if I hit Control Shift L again, that will remove my filters. I also have the option of Control 1, which will bring up my format cells, Control 2, which will bold, Control 3, which will italicize, Control 4, which will underline, Control 5, which will strike through, Control 9, which will hide a row over here, Control 0, which will hide a column. Alt equals will automatically sum all numbers above that cell. Control minus will bring up the delete dialog, and Control Shift Plus will bring up the insert dialog box. I know it's very difficult to memorize all of these, and you definitely won't the first time you do this. So maybe pick some of your favorites and start working with those, and hopefully it helps you to become more efficient with Excel. So in review, we covered some of the most common shortcuts that people use in Excel, and you can also use some of these shortcuts outside in other Microsoft products such as Word and PowerPoint. We covered how to access the ribbon using the keyboard and all of the commands that are on the ribbons. We covered some of the function keys, and then we covered how to navigate through a spreadsheet without using the mouse. And then finally, we just went over a couple other favorites. Hopefully you learned something new today. Thanks for watching our video this week, and hopefully we'll see you again next week.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions, and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.